sense of it, and you shall command to bring B'nai Israel, to bring all the pure olive oil to kindle and the eternal light in the duration of our lives, in the duration of our walk with God, in the duration of our existence here on earth. There are times that we are crushed, tested with suffering in one form or another. What we do with the crush testing is our choice. What we do with the trials, with the difficulties, these are our choices. We can be like Messiah Yeshua.
Bless you.
And turn that grind into something useful for somebody else along our journey. Or we can do the carnal thing and wallow in self-pity. Lord, why is this happening to me? I don't know why I accepted faith. Now I should just go back and do it. The Lord is trying to circumcise you, to remove some things from you, to make you into that holy garment that His Spirit may dwell within. Amen?
Amen.
All right, look, some of y'all are still sleeping. Amen?
Amen? Amen.
There we go. Thank you, Hillary. Thank you. The great scholars of the 20th century wrote that genius is 1% inspiration and 99%
perspiration.
There you go. Some guys know this one. So the grind that we go through, the crush testing that you and I endure, is part of the process, but we have to keep getting up and keep reflecting Messiah. Keep reflecting the goodness of God in order for you and I to grow. I find it amazing. Every year my father-in-law cuts the same tree. Every single year he cuts the same tree. And at the end of the time, from a distance, it looks like there's a guy in the yard. It's just, you know. That's how it looks. There's nothing else. It's just like this. And don't get me wrong, I love my father-in-law, so let me put that out there. That's the safety net there. I love my father-in-law. But every year he cuts it till there's nothing left on it, but it looks like that, right? But every year it grows. Every year there's more branches and fresh greenery around this thing than there was the time before. Every year this happens. So it's a process. Like the tree, you and I have to be pressed. We have to be cut. Amen?
Amen.
If not, we'll just go along our merry way thinking that everything is okay. But we have to choose to use our experiences and our growth process to lift others up. But in the same respect, we need to use it to lift ourselves up, to further our walk with Messiah.
Amen.
That is part of the purpose of it, right? When we don these holy garments, when we put the tzitzit on, or we walk with God, and mind you should be walking with Him every single day, Monday through Sunday.
Amen.
Or wait, Sunday through Saturday. There you go. Wrong calendar. Through Sunday through Saturday. There you go. Thank you. We have to be walking with our garments every day. And yes, like the Morah stated, some garments are for specific purposes. But walking with the Holy Spirit, walking with the truth, walking with God, is a daily occurrence. It is not when you feel like it. It is not when you're out in public. It's when you're behind closed doors. It's when you're hanging out with your homies. It's when you're in church with the holy people. Oh, yes, of course. Sorry. Pause. Okay. Youth, please. The Yedaim class is ready. That's you young guys, right? Y'all's teacher is ready for y'all. And the Chazak class, right? Did I get those both right? Okay. And the Chazak class, y'all are both ready to go. God, they say that whenever there's youth in a synagogue or in an assembly, that there is life and a future there.
Amen.
So genius is 1% inspiration, 99%
perspiration.
There you go. The word avodah, and I know some of the sisters here remember that word because it was associated with a particular dance group in San Antonio. And they were a fun bunch of people. But the word itself means service, or temple service, or striving, or prayer. And it means all these in one. So in you and I serving God, we begin to wear the Spirit. We begin to wear the Word within our being, within our vessel. Amen?
Amen.
And then the blood of Messiah becomes a relevant thing in your life. It's not just something that you do, that you plead when you're in trouble. Right? But it's something that you stand for, that you represent, that you exhibit in your life. A lot of times we'll get in trouble, and that's the only time God will hear from you. Right? You get in trouble, and it's, oh, Messiah, I plead the blood. God, rebuke this person, rebuke that. Maybe God's putting you through this so that way you will let go of some issues. Maybe you're blaming too many other people and the issue is right here. It's the person looking at you in the mirror. So, serving God applies to everything. Whether you're in the arts, whether you're in the sciences, whether you're in the business, or in the industry, whatever it is, serving God should be a part of your life. If you have a business, if you work somewhere, that's part of it. You honor God in your business. Yeshua says, do all things unto the glory of the King. What does that leave out? Does that leave anything out?
No.
When you go on a picnic, is that, you know? When you go for luncheon, when you're shopping with the girls, I don't do that, but when the guys go and they have the men's meetings, and by the way, for the announce it later. Since the Torah is the Word of God, who is infinite, the Torah itself is infinite. Infinite in time because it is eternally binding. Yeshua said, until heaven and earth pass away, God's word will continue and remain forever true.
Amen.
Earth is still here. We're still standing. And God's word is true. day.